All right, welcome back to the rest of the story. We're going to be doing some commentary with Relina, so if she decides to throw in some of her own opinions, that's who you're going to be hearing. So, we are tearing out a 40-plus-year-old fence. This is one of the first fences my dad put in when he started working for my grandpa, and I don't have much footage of actually tearing it out. It's woven wire, and I believe it had two strings of gaucho on top of it. And it took about 5 minutes to tear out because the vet showed up to give one of the dogs a shot. And in the 5 minutes that I was talking to the vet, my dad and uncle had already had the fence knocked over and was ready to start rolling it up. And this is a pretty quick way of rolling up this woven wire. Just once you get it going and just wrap it right up on itself. I mean, we don't have a whole lot of woven wire left on these farms. But this is probably the last like big stretch we had left. But the problem is that it was starting to lean over, and because this is the pasture going, well, it's the pasture at the home farm. You can see the silos in the back there. My cows weren't pushing it, but if they decided that they didn't want to be in it anymore, they probably could have given it a real run for its money. I guess I can't say that there is another stretch of woven wire in this pasture yet. Well, there's one more stretch of fence around this pasture at the home, or at the home farm, and then the whole pasture will have new fence all around it. I'm thinking about putting a hot wire around it, though, just because the pasture is overstocked, and once that grass is pretty well ground out, they're really gonna start pushing the fences, and we don't need that. I gotta haul a bunch of them out, but I got 5 calves to go yet, and I'll make decisions from there. And, yep, I agree, Relina. So, she's all giggles this morning. We weren't planning on doing this today at all. My Uncle Kevin showed up, so we decided to put him to work. I know he's watching, too. But the plan was, earlier in the day, Dad and I went and got the wood post to build this fence. Without the intentions of starting to work on it today, because I was going to work in the shed and get some of that machinery worked on. And one thing led to another, and went from, hey, let's tear that fence out, to, hey, it's not that late, let's go ahead and put the posts in, and, hey, it's not that late, let's go do the stakes. And we don't have all but one wire strung yet, because you'll see it here, the wire is needed to run between each of the end posts, the corner posts. Hi. To make sure that you have a nice straight fence. And here, Dad and I are lining up our gate that we had there to where our end post needs to be. The pasture, well, this fence was actually moved about a foot and a half in towards the pasture. Not because that was our intentions, but because that's where this ended up with this gate here on the other end of the pasture. Because we are planning on hanging this up, and we just want to make sure that it would work. So I know I don't got any footage of hooking up the driver, but we got the post pounder on the back of the 4020. Somebody asked me not that long ago if we missed the driver on the front of the open station 4020. Absolutely not. Hey, I need that. Relina's trying to take the microphone. I don't miss that. I mean, this one isn't super efficient, but it still works a lot better than digging them by hand, and it's really not that much different or inconvenient than the front mounted one. Honestly, for the guy that, like me, that is running the driver, it doesn't bother me. There's nothing wrong with it. If anything, it's an inconvenience for the driver, because when the post driver was mounted on the front of the tractor, you can see Dad there, he's having to turn around, strain his neck, and you're trying to run the brakes and the clutch. And the thing is, I sped this clip and the next one up just a little bit. There's minute little changes and adjustments that you make to it to make sure that you're pounding the post somewhat straight, and you're holding the clutch in quite a bit, as opposed to if it was on the front end. You're not straining around to see behind you, and you can see where you need to be a lot better. As far as stability, I don't really think the stability is that bad. The 4020 is narrowed up for cultivating. I mean, we did that a few years ago, and to be quite honest, if we got on some of this iffier ground, well, Rilina's going with mom. If we were on some of this iffier ground, the 7600 would easily go on to this post driver. We've had it on it before, and it was slower, but I also put all that money into the 76, and it's got a new hydraulic pump on it. So the 76, I know, could handle this just fine, which is nice, too, that it... I didn't like the front-mounted driver because it was a pain to hook and unhook. I mean, and to be honest with you, it always seemed like when we did go through and take it off the tractor, it was right about that time it was, you know, it'd be kind of nice if we had the driver on. We'd go pound a few posts, and in the end there, it ended up just staying on the tractor pretty well full-time, which then when you wanted to use the tractor for field work or for raking hay or whatever else, you had that driver hanging off the front of the tractor. And that driver, in my opinion, is just as the same as having a loader hanging off the front of a tractor, because we used to have that 7400 with the loader on it, and it had the loader on it over the winter. But when we were going to do oats, because I use the 74 for disking, it was common to at least go out and work those first 30 or 40 acres of the year with the loader on the 7400, and I didn't like it because every little bump that you hit, that loader would shake the whole tractor, and it was just uncomfortable. So we already got the string strung. Did I show that already? Wow, maybe I did, maybe I didn't. I don't know, I guess maybe I talked over it already. Sorry, I was watching Rilina. But yeah, we went the easy route as far as stringing that wire. We just sit in the back of the gator and hold the wire unroller. That actually, my Uncle Kevin, that's who's helping us here. My Uncle Kevin did what my grandpa used to do. We put in a 3/4 mile long fence out of my brother's place the last year that grandpa was on the farm. And that's what grandpa did to help. He actually was at the time, the Kawasaki mule runner. And grandpa actually absolutely loved that thing because he couldn't get on and off his four-wheeler anymore with his hips and his knees. And that had a bench seat in it so he could slide into it really easily. And that was his go-getter. And grandpa, that's how he helped us put fence in. He was running this wire. I mean, we'd load it up and everything for him, but we'd load it full of wire, we'd load it full of supplies, and he'd run it to the other end of the fence for anybody that needs parts. Also for running the wires, grandpa would run the mule for us across the whole stretch of it, and helped us that way, so that way he wasn't just sitting in the truck or stuck in the house, because at 80 years old or 80 plus years old, it gets kind of hard to walk on some of that uneven terrain, especially for how his farmer's body was feeling by that time. And driving posts is probably the most unfun part, mainly just because these posts are going to be here for, you know, years, so you want to try to get them in as straight as possible so you're not looking at a crooked post. So that's what my uncle is doing. He's eyeing up across. You can't see on the other end. He's trying to eye up the post to make sure that they're not out of line, and the wire is there. I'm pulling the wire back so I don't catch it. So you have that to kind of gauge off of so you can keep the fence somewhat in line. Coffee's back to bite me. And let's actually discuss the whole post pounder versus a hole digger. We've ran both. We've had the auger, the postal auger, in front of the skid steer. More tedious, more pain. I mean, maybe it helped you get the fence in a little straighter, but you're also burning that much more time filling the hole back in, tapping it down, and leaving the ground to settle. These posts, when you pound them in, they're solid. They're very solid. And I don't think I have it, but I took a picture of it. Actually, back in March, this fence was leaning over, so I went and we put in two steel stakes, and I actually pounded one of the steel stakes into the old post that was rotted off. I didn't realize it. Oh, here we go. serves me right for not ordering these clips up better. This is all we used to do for, well, it beats pulling it by hand for rolling the wire out. And you go 2, 3, 4 miles an hour, and it saves your legs, saves your arms. I mean, you gotta be careful when you get this roll down towards the end when it starts to catch on itself, because you see I'm using my leg, which is probably unapproved. Kevin's saying hi. Kind of unapproved for doing it, but when that roll gets down to where it's almost out and it catches, it'll actually pull you right off the back of the gator or the mule back one. And we're going to see a nice, slightly overcast sky, a little blue, and Ryan working on pounding the steel post in, steel stake in. Don't worry, I do find the camera here in a little bit. We actually put the stakes in, went in probably about the fastest. The wood posts take a little bit more time because we had to go through and pace out where each of the posts need to go. And then the steel stakes are, you know, the 6 foot long stakes. So we just, the length of the stakes and put them in. So we don't have any wires on. That'll be the plan for today. And we'll have a nice 6 wire fence to hold the cows in. Well, cows, not so much the calves. Calves really don't get held in by much anymore. They can actually walk right through this fence if they really wanted to, even the new one. I mean, they're small enough yet, and I've seen calves just kind of run straight, run forward, and that's why when you tag them, you got to try to aim them back towards their mom or something, because hopefully she'll slow them down and they don't just keep running, because I've had them do that. All right, any time trap. There we go. So we have, what's going on here? With four of us, this went incredibly quick because my uncle, we have the steel stakes on the front of the skid steer. My uncle's driving along with us. Ryan and I are running the steel stake drivers. And my dad is going through and he's setting the steel stakes up for us. So we just, he's got them where we need to be and just put them down. And a pretty good day to do this. I don't know if you could really tell when the camera was looking up the sky. The wind was pretty wicked, and they're calling for, today is the day, today is Friday, they're calling for the 28 degree weather. So, not too bad for starting on the fence at 2 in the afternoon, and by 6 o'clock that night, we are on the downhill slide of having it done. So, that's all I got for video for this, guys. So, thanks for watching. Thanks for tuning in. Take care. Take it easy. Keep in touch. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Bye.